the Straighten Image dialog, there is a new Correct Lens Distortion slider that helps you preview and adjust your image to quickly and easily remove pincushion and bower distortions. Pincushion distortions make photos appear pinched in from the centre, while bower distortions, which is what we have here, make photos appear pushed out from the centre. By dragging the slider to the left, you can reduce bower distortions. Conversely, by dragging the slider to the right, you can reduce pincushion distortions. By using the customizable grid, you can quickly realign the distortion. You can use the new Planar mask tool to define a feathered and editable area along parallel lines. You can modify the mask by moving or rotating the lines. And you can also use mask modes with the Planar mask tool. When combined with the new Bokeh Blur effect, you can simulate tilt shift photography and create a miniature scene by giving focus to an area while blurring areas outside of the planar mask. There are also new camera effects such as Colorize, Sepia Toning and Time Machine to help you recreate historic photographic styles and give your images unique visual appearances. You can create a duotone image by using the Colorize effect to replace all colors in an image with a single hue. The Sepia Toning effect simulates a photo taken with sepia film, which is similar to grayscale except it uses brown tones. And the Time Machine lets you choose from 7 historical photographic styles ranging from 1839 to the 1960s to give your photos a vintage look. This concludes our overview of some of the new effects in Corel Photo Paint X7. But Photo Paint also includes various new tools and creative options for retouching photos, such as the liquid tools and unsharp mask lens. So please check out some of the other videos to see some of the new features in action.